who gives this woman of God to be married to this man of God, that the Lord Jesus Christ may be honored in this holy union. Sorry, sister, I had a brain freeze for a second. Let me talk to you, the guests, first. There's a passage of scripture in the Gospel of John. Hear the word of the Lord. Very truly, I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way, is a thief and a robber. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls out his own sheep by name, and he leads them out. And when he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them. But his sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from a stranger because they don't recognize the stranger's voice. Jesus used this figure of speech, but the Pharisees didn't understand what he was telling them. So Jesus said again, I have other sheep that are not in this sheep pen, and I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me, and I give them eternal life. And they shall never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. Okay, girl, now go sit with your mother, because now you're going to be a part of her family. I love my sheep. Now I want to talk to you guys, Will and Haley. Marriage is God's idea, and we just read from the scripture, not a specific marriage passage. I'll read a specific marriage passage in a moment. I read that passage, Haley. It had some familiar words in it to you and I, sheep. And one of the things we've learned about you is that you are passionate about your spiritual journey. And I know that you have lofty, lofty dreams, and yet you are rooted in reality. You know the voice of the Good Shepherd, you are following where he leads you. In the passage of scripture that I read, and I encourage you to read it again, the path that he is taking you on from verses 10 through 16 in John chapter 10 will be a mixed bag for you. There will be, in the passage it talks about, abundant living. But in the calling that God has placed upon your life, Pastor talks about the wolves that will devour many of the sheep. And you are going to see so many carcasses that the wolves have devoured as you continue in your journey. But you're going to find sheep to bring into the sheep pen. Now that marriage passage, well, 1 Corinthians chapter 7. Now, for the matters you wrote about, it is good for a man not to have sexual relations with a woman. But since sexual immorality is occurring, each man should have sexual relations with his own wife. It's in the Bible. And each woman her own husband. The husband should fulfill his duty to his wife, and likewise the wife fulfill her duty to her husband. The wife does not have authority over her own body, but yields it to her husband. In the same way, the husband does not have authority over his own body, but he yields it to the wife. Don't deprive each other, except by mutual consent for a time, so that you may devote yourselves to prayer. Then you come together again, so that Satan will not tempt you because of your lack of self-control. Now, I say this as a concession, not as a command. I wish that all of you were single like I am. This is the Apostle Paul speaking. But each of you has your own gift from God. Some, like Pastor Pat and Diana, have the gift of marriage. Others have the gift of singleness. To the unmarried, to the widow, I say, it is good for them to stay unmarried. But if they can't control themselves, they should marry. They should marry. They should marry. Well, there is so much more about what God has called you to do that I'm going to tell you right now you do not understand yet. It's not because of your will. That's true of every man who has stood where you are standing right now. The reason we take vows in weddings is because little do we know what better or worse means, richer or poorer, means sickness and health. In a word, God has called you to be a husband. Now you have two options. You can settle for the Americanized version of a husband, and that requires nothing of you. Do whatever you want. If you choose that, remember that I told you, no pain, no gain. This is as good as it will ever get, is the way it is today. You can choose option two and learn to be the husband to Haley that God says in this passage of scripture is your duty. Because I and other godly husbands we will pour into you what a godly husband is. But I promise you will, it's going to be like drinking from a fire hydrant. You are marrying a woman who is not going to slow down spiritually. So we will pour into you so you can be the husband she needs. So, will, marriage vows. Turn to your fiancé.
On my desk.
Share your vows. They told me they were going to do their own vows. So this has been first in 154 different ways. What vows do you have for your fiancé?
I don't think more than I can even express. Because so many times I've been ripped apart. My things that we have no control over. And things that we did it ourselves. Today I choose to see my life.
Rings. Your rings serve as a perpetual reminder of the vows that you have just made to each other. I heard both of you say the word forever. Well, if you place your hand out, please, and let me place this ring with you. Will, prepare now to seal your vows with this symbol of your love as you place it on the finger of your bride and you say to her,
I will,
with this ring,
take your name,
to be my wife,
and by this hand,
declare in the presence of God. God.
Declaring the presence of God.
And our family.
And our friends and family.
I will be with you.
I will be with you.
A faithful husband.
A faithful husband.
And if ever, Haley, if you'll put out your hand and take this ring from me, and allow this ring to serve as evidence that you will keep your marriage vows, placing it upon Will's finger and say to him,
I
with this ring.
Thank you, Will.
Just as real as their salvation experience was when you called them out of darkness and into your life, do this supernatural work of taking these two individuals and making them one, like praying in the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Will and Haley, since you have consented together in holy wedlock, and because you love each other, as your shepherd, as your pastor, in the church that you call home, I declare that you are one of the two, a one, husband and wife, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Will and Haley Edmonton.
Congratulations.
Oh!
Comes out very good.